Right, hello, welcome to Guitar Shack, the Golden Jubilee edition, and
Diamond the Jubilee even.
Is it?
Yeah.
Diamond? Oh, yeah. Christ, there you go, shows how much I know. Anyway, so we've got a special, okay, as special as we can get, you know, not special.
On a limited budget.
Yeah. So, here we go, on someone's limited budget, who will remain nameless, we've got two amps to compare. This is made by Ibanez. It's a T5.
No, Mark, it's a TSA 30.
Oh, there you go. They can't even write the word five properly. Go on then. What
and
is it?
It's an Ibanez TSA 30, which is a 30 watt version of the one they did recently, which is like a 15 watt head
and a cab. That.
And they've also done now a 15 watt combo, and that's the 30 watt version. And right. We tested the 15 watt a year ago.
And this sells for?
430 ish.
Right. This one.
Hiwatt T20.
And that sells for?
I've seen that on eBay for $325.
New?
Brand new. All right, so 20 watt for the Hiwatt, 30 watt for the Ibanez. A few things. The Hiwatt's obviously got reverb. The Ibanez doesn't have reverb. It's got a built in tube screamer apparently as well.
Yeah. Well, the idea of it is.
We'll see the value of that.
Is because without wishing to give too much away, I thought this sounded like a dump pile of shit. And I preferred this because it's more classic old school tone. So we're going to just really try and just do a quick swap over. Neil comes up the leads over. So we're going to do a clean test. So first is the Hiwatt, yeah?
Yeah.
So think of something appropriately quiet to play. So I don't know.
Swap over?
Yeah, we'll do a swap over, so it's a direct comparison. Turn up on the quiet channel a little bit, but so what do you think? This one I think sounds warmer, more rounded to me.
When we first played the Ibanez, I did agree with you that I thought it sounded like a pile of crap.
A bit soulless, really.
However, when you listen to them back to back, is it just the reverb making a difference on the Hiwatt? I don't know.
You can turn the reverb off.
Yeah. The Hiwatt.
Turn the reverb
better.
Off.
Let's turn it off.
Bitch!
There's not a lot of reverb on it, so.
If I plugged in the right hand, wouldn't it?
Well, play the Ibanez then.
Alright. Okay, something else. So that's the clean setting. Now, I did say initially to put all the settings dials the same, you know, bass and treble and everything, but then I realised quite quickly that you can't really do that because they all operate in different ways, so you've got to try and get the best sound out of both of them. I mean, the finish build quality is good. This is a bit crap because it hasn't got these hard corners on it. You're going to knock this and the Tolex is going to split, and Christ knows why amp manufacturers insist on doing that. But they keep on shortchanging it. I mean, they both look great. This looks really nice, old-fashioned, more old-fashioned. As you hear, the tones we'll get when we crank it up, it's more old and, is it American? I don't know. It's
well, that's the sort of the Who. Sort of
sound,
isn't
it? Sounds like early new wave of British heavy metal to me, but you, and I'll do a bit of Saxon for you so you can see that. That's the only thing I've learnt this week.
Showing your age. Yeah.
Okay, so here we go then. Let's go on loud now then. Can you do the business on that?
What do you mean? Press the channel button.
You always need someone to have their fingers to press buttons. Yes. The wiper. Okay, still prefer my Marshall, but there you go.
Three times the price.
I know. It's worth it though. Right, this is the tube screamer one. So we flip some stupid little
tube
button screamers. Down here.
Tube screamer.
That one?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this, I think, is where you see the difference between the two amps.
Yeah. It's not very loud or crunchy, is it? Let me just dial up. I have to switch the flip. Hold on, where's the bloody game? Is that the game there?
No, the game for the tube screen is on far to the left.
Oh, it's on full. So I need to turn the volume down and really drive this bitch. My disappointment with this was probably down to the fact we didn't really turn the settings up and things like that. This definitely lacks bottom end though. You compare it to this one. There's a lot more bottom end. Interesting.
Turning the treble down seems to reduce the sort of presence of it.
Yeah. I don't know, it just lacks some drive. The thing that I thought about this was that the amp was more of a process sound. I don't know whether the tubes... Is there tubes
yep,
in here?
Yep.
Yeah, there's at least four of them in there. Some big ones in there, but they've just changed much around the circuitry. This one here. I mean... seems a little bit more organic than this one. That's the difference. This is more of a true classic valve amp. This one is some sort of weird hybrid thing. I suppose it's down to your own personal choice what guitar you use and things like that, really. Me, if I was going to get a combo, I'd probably get a Marshall, or a Laney actually. We did try a Laney out that someone brought around. We didn't get to video it, but that was damn good. But the price difference between this and this is
not £100.
£100, yeah. What flexibility have you got for foot switches and things like that?
They both take a foot switch.
Right.
The Hiwatt gives you the channel and the reverb.
Yeah.
And the Ibanez gives you effectively tube screamer on and off, and that boost, there's a 6 dB boost switch, so it'll give you that as well.
I dare say that both of these amps would function more efficiently at higher volumes, really. And to that end, we're having a studio built, or I'm building it, when Niels is helping out with bits and pieces. And if you can see it behind us, I don't know if you can, but there's a dirty great sort of like shed type garage thing. We're going to have that for recording, and we're going to be doing reviews, so we'll be able to crank them up to mercilessly ear-crushing volume. So maybe if you get some little combos in the future, we'll be able to go, you know, put them on 10.
Or even 11.
Yeah, I don't think even these could go up to 11, mate. But if you're on a combo, they're both okay. Initially, when I tried this last week, because we were going to review it, and I couldn't be bothered, I just thought, I can't stand it, it's rubbish, I didn't like it. But it's actually performed a bit better in direct comparison to this.
Surprisingly.
And it probably needs a bit more tweaking than we've actually done. So if you like the, you know, hopefully you'll hear some difference in the sound.
Do put the reverb on the Hiwatt, because it sounded really quite sweet with the reverb.
Well, you need given to do that. I can't see it.
Given that the Ibanez doesn't cover the reverb, and so you pay your money, you get what you get.
Good point.
It's worth trying it with the reverb.
Okay. Not very loud, the reverb.
Can you turn it down?
Bury it in reverb. Okay.
When you hear it.
Yeah, so reverb for people like me who like to hide a lot of stuff is good.
Play your version of Sweet Home Alabama on both of them to finish up. Because I think it's a good little.
Was it on clean, yeah?
It's not.
Clean. Well, I think it's a nice little test. My manky version of Sweet Home Alabama. Outside. Too bad, did it?
No, I think the Hiwatt sounded better. But
Yeah, you can make your own decisions. So, anyway, good luck, Queenie. Hopefully, you'll live a few more years to keep pulling the tourists in, because we need the money right now. Okay, catch you later.